Hi guys.
Hi.
So how can we have a little bit of background on Casino Royale and how did you guys meet, come together, and I suppose you took a long break as well, so maybe you can give us a bit of an idea about that as well.
Yeah, it's a long story so far. We started about 20 years ago, but in the middle we had a break of something, 9 years, 8 years and a half, because one of the two singers of the band quit. So we took a while to, you know, kind of stand by, and in the meanwhile we grew up our families, having babies and doing different stuff. We started like every band started. I think we were friends. We were going out in the same place. So then we gathered together, the same musical tastes and everything. And so we started as a kind of play. Then it became a profession quite soon, I must say.
It was the second half of the 80s, so it
was,
you know.
87. With 87, we started like being kind of a ska band. It was it was kind of a time of kind of revival of the, of all the, you know, just a little bit before it was all those, you know, the Spatial Madness, so all the second, you know, ska, let's call it ska invasion of the UK.
So
we, yeah, two-tone kind of sound. So we started from there, but then we go soon after that straight to the origin of ska, so rock stage and everything. So we were very interested from where that kind of music were coming from.
Okay.
But from the beginning, we used to be not really close, musically speaking, but open mind, because we grew up listening new wave, so electronic music, to black music, funk and reggae, dub, and then and at the beginning of the 90s we enjoyed also hip hop, and we started to make this blended sound of Casino Royale. Every record was something different. Then in the first half of 90s we came out with this album Dynamite. It was kind of crossover with black rock influence, hip hop, lovers rock, and
yeah, we were always open to all different influences that came from members of the band. So one was more close to funk, and so we had some funk influences. We used to collaborate with a lot of different kind of musicians, even DJs.
Okay.
I think we were kind of first band in Italy or something to use a DJ on stage.
Okay.
And on the record too, so.
So that comes kind of close to the collaboration, I suppose, with Howie B, and that connects into that. And how did that come about?
I mean, we're always looking abroad from Italy to try to make our product. And we used to go to catch the vibe in London to compose, also to mix. We was looking for an international sound, because we are Italian, but we got right prejudice and hating a lot of Italian music, the classic cliche of Italian music, like mandolino and, you know, really nice singer and harps and choirs and blah blah blah. So we always try to find an international sound, so we collaborate with the people from Bristol, and also we start working on electronic music too, much more in drum and bass, and we open our label and collaborate with people from London, and Awi was friend of our friends. Of course, the first time we met Awi was during the Pop Mart 2, the U2 tour, and because we play in Rome, like opening act, and in Reggio Emilia, and we met him before. It was DJing, right?
Yeah.
And after that, I met him in the studio, because I used to work like organizer of workshop, and I called him, and was the first time that I saw him working in the studio properly. He was not like an electronic producer, but he was really a studio guy. And when we decided, when we signed the contract with V2 after 9 years to come back in studio, we immediately understand that we need to collaborate with someone.
Mm.
First of all, because we need a referee to make the right balance.
Not to fight between us.
between us. And we want to find a person outside out our state of mind, because it was 9 years of breaks. We used to work a lot with computer and electronic, but we are a live band, so there was a little bit, you know, a little bit of help and that we needed. We contact him, and it was so funny because okay, we the world, we were a really big budget. So he say, hi, how are we? We are Italian band. We meet him before. Do you wanna collaborate with us? And what he done is, you know, make a telephone call of a couple of friends in Italy. Say, what about this band? And all these people say, wow, it's, you know, it's a seminal band. It's a really important band for Italian scene. So it was really cool to start to work with us. So we make this deal quickly. We send an MP3 to him. He was, you know, answering us with the vibe and things, vision, something. But when we get in the studio, the second day we start playing, he comes to me and say, you're fucking lucky because you got a really nice team. We say, wow, thank a lot for asking me to come. And I was a little bit embarrassed because, you know, it was him to say thank you to us. I said, oh, and it was great because I think that he's a really nice coach, basically. And it's really important for a band that work in studio with a producer, have a person that let everybody feels, you know,
express everybody, yeah, really freely, and he knows how to, you know, how to coordinate different people together. So he's a producer.
So
and he was really focused to let us play live. Because and I'll tell you before, we come in also for electronic music experience, and the album was great. It was great experience, direct, a proper album made by a band. But we miss something. I mean, there was this feeling to make something more experimental, more dance or electronic.
So
and I always try to say to Arwen, okay, push this, push that, and say, okay, what we're gonna do is finish this album and start to make another project that is the dub version of the album. This guy from
You've answered my next question already. Go ahead. Yeah, because the next question is obviously, how did the Howie B versus Casino Royale come about? Which is what you were going to tell me
about.
Yeah,
it was so natural, actually, because it was a proposal from him, from himself. So it came out like that, like we were trying to push him on a more kind of electronic or experimental kind of sound, and say, okay, let's do a different version. And so we planned it, and finally we did it. And I must say that he had such a radical approach to it that we were kind of astonished. So we were thinking about, okay, could he remix this album that he already produced? And he followed the best way he could, I think, that he did a very, you know, extreme and radical and very interesting kind of, it's very atmospheric, it's not about, you know, songs like the album is. The album was 10 songs, proper songs, except from one instrumental, but it was a proper, you know, let's say a pop album. And he did a very kind of, you know, very slow, atmospheric kind of dub, dance album.
Yeah, in a roots radical way to mix it, because it's a proper dub way to produce an album. So open up again all the channels, put a delay, make a sequence with a delay, compression, like a really old school way. Not proper electronic. I think that even if it's not a reggae dub album, it's a really dub approach to this job. And so we are really happy because it's strange that producer come and say, hey, I want to do this, please, okay. And I think that we was really lucky to find a really nice guy like him.
Well, he's a big fan of your band, he told me. So, and he was really excited about working with you. And it sounds great.